From UFOs to psychic powers and government conspiracies, history is riddled with unexplained events. You can turn back now, or learn the stuff they don't want you to know. Here are the facts. Located primarily in Mali, the Dogon people have a rich cultural heritage, including a stunning array of oral traditions, architecture, and sculptures. Their carved masks are renowned throughout the world for their skill and artistry. They also have a complex set of spiritual beliefs, focusing on ancestors and mythical beings called the Nomo. Referred to both as a group and as a single being, the Nomo are worshipped as spiritual guardians. Some of West Africa's oldest textile fragments have been found in Dogon territory, and scholars have extensively researched this tribe. While there's no denying that the Dogon have a fascinating history, some believe their religion holds something more than conventional spiritual beliefs. They believe the Dogon may have proof of alien life. Here's where it gets crazy. In a book called The Serious Mystery, author Robert Temple claims the Dogon have inexplicably sophisticated knowledge of astronomy, especially of the Sirius star cluster. Temple claims the Nomo myths contain revelations that predate modern astronomic discoveries. According to Marcel Grial, an anthropologist who met the Dogon in the 1930s, the tribe had an extremely advanced understanding of astronomy. Dogon traditions state that the Nomo originated from a planet near Sirius. In these legends, the Nomo taught the Dogon about Sirius, including the cluster's primary star, Sirius A. The Nomo also taught the Dogon about Sirius B, a white dwarf star orbiting Sirius A. Sirius B wouldn't be visible with the technology the Dogon possessed. According to Grial, they also knew of Jupiter's moons and Saturn's rings. So how did they come across this knowledge? For fringe researchers, the answers found in the Nomo, and proof of the Nomo can be found in similar myths such as the Babylonian creatures known as the Enidoti. Skeptics chalk these claims up to confirmation bias. It's more likely that the Dogon practiced a religious syncretism, blending pre-existing beliefs from different sources to create a spiritual system. So what about Sirius B? Carl Sagan notes that West Africa was far from historically isolated. He also believed the Dogon would have needed outside help, but he believed it was probably help from Earth. While the Dogon may not have had the technology to locate Sirius B on their own, they had an abiding interest in astronomy. It's quite possible that earlier explorers could have met the Dogon and, if so, they almost certainly would have discussed astronomy. Additionally, Grial's findings weren't comprehensive. He spoke to only a few Dogon and did so through an interpreter. If Sagan is correct, then early anthropologists may have simply misinterpreted the Dogon's claims. While NASA didn't produce the first photo of Sirius B until 1970, discussion of Sirius was widespread in the 1920s. At heart, this is another ancient astronaut theory. Skeptics note that we don't need claims of alien intervention to explain human ingenuity. For the proponents of these theories, the problem isn't proof. Instead, it's a rigid academic hierarchy that refuses to seriously research unorthodox possibilities. As for the Dogon perspective, it's important to remember that this is a belief system, not a scientific theory. But for those who desire more proof for or against this story, there's one last detail. The Dogon belief system still has secrets that aren't readily revealed to outsiders, and some that may be completely unknown in the Western world. It may not be proof of extraterrestrial contact, but the Dogon still have stuff they don't want you to know.